Hi, I'm Andy from Autodesk Navisworks. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can customize the Autodesk Navisworks interface to make your workflows more efficient. When I open Autodesk Navisworks, I work in the interface you can see here. This interface is known as the workspace. The workspace shown here is one of the pre-configured workspaces, the minimal workspace. Autodesk Navisworks has a number of pre-configured workspaces, each one providing a different interface layout. If I open the extended workspace, for example, you can see that additional tabs and dockable windows are now shown in the interface so that these tools are quickly accessible. For now, though, I want to show you how you can create your own personalized workspace with the tools you need for specific activity quickly accessible. Let's suppose that for each new project, I spend time categorizing the model items by their property values. Well, I can set up a nice, clear workspace with only the tools I need for this process on display. Let's start by looking at what you can do with the ribbon. The ribbon area groups related tools in a series of tabs. So for example, all the viewpoint tools are stored on the same tab. The ribbon on your interface won't necessarily look the same as I have here. That's because different add-ins, settings, etc. can give you additional ribbon options. On each tab, related tools are further grouped into specific panels. So on the viewpoint tab, they're split into tools for save, load and playback, camera, navigate, render style, and sectioning. To help you out, if you hover over a particular tool, then a tooltip will describe what the tool does. You can also drag panels off the ribbon and move them to where you want in the workspace. Now, look how I can minimize the ribbon so that it takes a little bit less room on the screen. As I move the mouse over the tabs, you can see that all the ribbon tools are still just a click away. Alternatively, I can hide the ribbon entirely like this and still access the tools when I need them. Okay, now let's display the ribbon again, because I want to show you how you can customize the tools and panels on the ribbon to be specific to your own needs. First, I'm going to show you how to hide a tab that you don't need for this particular workflow. In this case, I'm going to remove the animation tab. It's pretty easy. Just right-click on the top line where the tabs are, hover over the Show Tabs option, and click on the tab you don't want to be seen. If you want to restore it at any stage, just repeat the process or click Restore Default Ribbon. Now again, there might be certain panels that you don't need. For this workflow, I don't need to have the Tools panel displayed. To remove this panel, just right-click on the ribbon, hover over Show Panels, and click Tools. And there, it's gone. As with the tabs, if you want to reverse the process, then just repeat the step. As well as using the ribbon, the Quick Access Toolbar has shortcuts to tools that you use regularly. By default, it contains standard tools such as Save, Refresh, Select, and so on. I can also add tools to the toolbar myself. So, say I use the Measure tool all the time, well, I can just right-click here, choose Add to Quick Access Toolbar, and there it is. Of course, it's still available on the ribbon as well. And if I decide to remove it from the Quick Access Toolbar, then it's easy, see? And if it's looking a bit cluttered, then I can also toggle the default icons off and on as I want. I can even move the toolbar to below the ribbon so that it's closer to the scene view, giving me even quicker access. I'll move it back to the top for now though. Oh, and essential tools such as Open, Save, Import, Export, Publish and Print can also be accessed by clicking the Application button. Okay. Now let's have a look at how I can customize dockable windows. First of all, I want to hide all of the windows that I don't need. I can close them by clicking the cross in the top corner of each window, or I can just click the Windows button on the View tab and remove them one by one. I'm going to keep the Selection tree and Sets, Properties and Find Items windows. These are the ones I want instant access to for this workflow. There, all gone. Now see how the Selection tree and Properties window are pinned open. That's good, because I want them there. But the Sets and Find Items windows, they're on what we call auto-hide, which means that when I start using other tools, they'll automatically be hidden again. It's a great feature if I'm only using them occasionally, but for this workflow, I want to keep them open. All I need to do is open them and click the pushpin button, and they'll attach to the scene view. That Find Items window looks a bit big, so I'll just resize it. There we go. Actually, I think I want the Sets window to be over by the Properties window. I can drag it from its current position, and I could just leave it floating like this if I wanted, but I'll use the docking tool, which automatically positions it in the scene view. I can even group windows together so that I can toggle between them. I just drag the Sets window onto the title bar of the Properties window, and there, they're grouped so I can just switch between them as I want. For this workflow though, I want to be able to see both windows, so I'll just ungroup them again. There, perfect. Okay, now I'm pretty happy with the way I've got things laid out now. This is definitely going to help me work more efficiently. I just need to save this layout so I can use it again in future. All I do is save it as a workspace, accept the default system location, and give it a suitable name. Let's call it User1. Now next time I want to use this workspace in Autodesk Navisworks, I just select it via the Load Workspace button. And it's all there, ready for me to start working. So there you go. Now that you know how to customize the interface, you can try it yourself and create more efficient workspaces for your own workflows. Thanks for watching.